What is up, everyone? Today we've got a really cool little audio related project. Today I'm going to be installing a very simple but hopefully quite effective and nice sounding sound system into the kitchen of all places. Now a tiny bit of backstory. Basically, since we moved in around 6 months ago, we've been using a 1980s FM radio in the kitchen, little portable radio. It's been really great. It's a lovely sounding radio. I really like just turning the radio on in the morning, you know, breakfast time, getting a little bit of the news, hearing a few different tracks, and you know, it's great. But where that sort of system falls short is definitely in the night time, times where the reception gets bad, and also times where I don't really want to listen to the radio, and maybe as I'm cooking or maybe as I'm doing the dishes. And I know Jess feels the same way. You know, we just want to choose our own tracks or choose our own album to listen to while doing those things. So the radio is not going anywhere. I love a kitchen radio. Like I said, breakfast time, perfect. But we also want to put in a sound system that will allow us to listen to our own music. So what I've decided to do is get another one of these little Lepi LP2020A amplifiers, or Lepi amplifiers, they're all the same. Now, if you guys want to see a much more in-depth video about this amplifier, you know, outside of the whole project, then as you guys can see, I've actually already got one. And if you've missed it, I will put a link or an annotation or whatever they are on the screen right now, and you guys can go and check out my previous video specifically looking at one of these amplifiers where I talk about, you know, just the amp and how it's performing and whatever. I can't even remember what I really talk about. But anyway, I've gone for another amplifier because they are small, they sound good, and they are cheap, and that's pretty much it. They're very flexible, they're extremely lightweight. It's just sort of, it avoids having a big hi-fi component in your kitchen. It's a nice way to have an amplifier for some separate speakers, but without being too massive. And of course, they've got mounting points on them. They're extremely flexible in terms of where you can put them. So that's that. I'm going to put that back there for a second. We will unbox it in a minute. So what speakers am I using? Well, unfortunately, I don't have the speakers here at the moment. I'll be going to get those later. I was meant to bring them back the other day, but I completely forgot. I'll basically be using the two speakers that I used to use for the front left and right channels of my bedroom surround sound system at my parents' house. So if any of you guys remember those, they were high up on the wall in IMNC HQ Mark 1. They are the speakers I will be using for this setup. They're not brilliant speakers, but they're pretty good. I think they came with sort of like a mid-level sort of mini stack hi-fi system maybe 10 years ago, something like that. Can't even remember what the make is, but I bought them for a fiver in a car boot sale. So fiver for those, 20 quid for this, and also one of these. Now, this is sort of like a permanent temporary solution, or a temporary permanent solution. This is a Bluetooth 3.5 millimeter dongle. It basically transforms any non-Bluetooth device into a Bluetooth device just by having a little Bluetooth receiver with a 3.5 millimeter output on it. Now, I've never ever used one of these, but for around a tenner, you can't go wrong. And that means that this entire project, even with cabling, this, that, and the other, is way below 50 quid, which is great. So why have I gone for one of these? Well, at first I wanted to put an AirPort Express in the kitchen, and that is still definitely something that I want to do. However, funds at the moment do not allow for another AirPort Express purchase, plus it would only be for this project. So splashing out straight away was a little stupid. So I thought, if I grabbed one of these, this is basically very similar functionality. Obviously, you're using Bluetooth as opposed to a networked solution, which is obviously not quite as streamlined. You know, you've got to connect to the device, you've got to make sure you turn your Bluetooth on your phone and stuff. I don't really use Bluetooth devices, so it'll take a little bit of time getting used to, you know, enabling my Bluetooth and things. But in terms of wireless music, it's pretty much this very similar functionality. This will be almost like a test, and when we're happy with this, I can be like, okay, now we'll add an AirPort Express, and it can be part of the network and connect with Wi-Fi and everything. And of course, one of the big pluses is this needs charging via USB. The AirPort Express will run on the mains, so that'll be a big plus. Anyway, already over 5 minutes of rambling. Let's dig into this and dig into this. And what we're going to do is just use these speakers for now that I have on my bench here, just to test this, because I don't want to go any further until I make sure that this and this works. And yeah, I don't really know what to expect. Never used one of these, but in this age where Bluetooth speakers seem to be all the rage, you know, everyone seems to be buying Bluetooth speakers, they're absolutely everywhere. These are pretty damn cheap alternatives if you've already got a sound system that doesn't have Bluetooth. Plus, it gives you quite a bit more flexibility. Guaranteed, this amplifier with the speakers I'll be using will sound one hell of a lot better than even quite a lot of expensive Bluetooth speakers that'll be double the price of a setup like this. But anyway, let's get into this impossibly hard to open packaging. Got my knife because it's one of these blister packs. Absolutely awful. So, after completely butchering the packet, here it is. Now, at first feel, first look, first glance, whatever, we've got a very, very lightweight dongle, so it can indeed dangle out of the input of the amplifier without damaging anything. This is a very nice feeling, sort of really soft, almost like a fabric kind of coating to this little dongle. We've got a button on it, and we also have a tiny little USB for charging there. So that is it, very basic bit of kit, tenor, very simple. What else do we have in here? I think I've sawed the instructions in half by the looks of it. But there is something else down here, and I assume it is the charging cable. Oh, look at that. I haven't sawn the instructions in half. That's good. So here we have some instructions, I believe. Let's have a look. Yeah, user's manual. I can go over there. And here we have the charging cable. Now, interestingly enough, folks, I don't have any kind of USB output anywhere in the kitchen. That is one thing that I haven't thought about. I could permanently leave this attached if I come up with some kind of USB power solution. I may be able to get a transformer for this amplifier, which I can sort of bodge something in for USB as well. Who the heck knows? But for now, the battery life, I believe, lasts... How long does it say the battery life lasts for? It says up to 10 hours of music playback on a single charge, which is fantastic. And while I'm here, a couple of the other specifications, you can be up to 10 meters away, and also you can pair up to 6 devices at a time to this, which is really cool. So quite a powerful little tool, and if it works reliably, I'll be very impressed with it. One other little note, this is obviously also really good for car audio use. If you've got an aux input and you want to use Bluetooth but you don't want to replace your entire stereo, then this would be really good in a car scenario as well, or any scenario. These are extremely flexible because of their size and weight. Anyway, let's dig into the amplifier. So I yet again, just like the last time I purchased one of these, I purchased it with the power adapter. So as you can see, it comes with the power adapter there, and it comes with the instructions, a bit of polystyrene, but it is indeed identical to my previous unit. And of course, on the back, we don't get much simpler than getting this thing. Let me just unplug it from the USB for a second and sticking it into the input there, and then that would just dangle and live behind the amplifier wherever I put the amplifier. So that's cool. Obviously, I can sort of maybe tie it up out of the way, double-sided tape or something like that. But anyway, what I'm going to do now, folks, is quickly plug in the amp, plug in a speaker. I'm not going to plug in 2 speakers, just going to plug in 1 because of convenience. And we are going to test the functionality of this little Bluetooth adapter. So guys, a bit of handheld camera work while we figure this out. Basically, I held down the button, and by the way, all this is now connected. So we got a speaker and power to the amp as well. So let's turn the amp on, give it a bit of volume. So yeah, this is now flashing, which I assume, or it was flashing. I assume that indicates that it is ready to be paired. Let's try that again. Obviously, I could just read the instructions to get... it made a noise through the amp there. Okay, so that's switched on, ready to pair. That's quite cool. There's all... So let's turn Bluetooth on. And what we'll do is connect to the device. There we go. I didn't hold the button long enough. So it flashes red and blue, and we will connect to that. So finally, we are now paired. It took ages to connect. So what we'll do is we'll go into music. So we'll play this track again because it's great for non-copyright. One thing I really like about this is the volume works over Bluetooth. So I can leave the amp at a set level and we can control the volume of the system with our mobile devices, which is great. So as you can pretty much tell, it's working really well. The only thing I don't really know is, like, will this auto shut down and start up? You know, obviously this is just a 3.5mm connection, so it won't know when the amplifier is on or not. But then again, I don't want to waste battery, so that's something that I'm kind of curious about. But again, I've never used one of these before. If it doesn't sense any activity, it'll probably just shut down after X amount of time, but could just stay active. I've got no idea how it works, but it's working anyway. Don't pack those bags too full, my friend. Which is awesome. Really pleased. So after about 5-6 minutes of testing, I can confirm that everything is working brilliantly. You do power the device on and off. I've read the instructions. So yeah, whatever. That doesn't actually make much of a difference, especially if I can think of a permanent USB power solution, which should not be too difficult actually. So yeah, as I say, really pleased with that so far. So for me, this is pretty much it. Luckily for you guys, I'll just do a cut and I'll be back with you with some speakers, but for me, I've got to get on with some other things before we go and fetch speakers. So I'm looking forward to continuing with this. So far, so good, folks. I'm pleased that this works. Good morning, everyone. It is the next day, and it is the morning, so apologies for my non-woken-up voice. But anyway, yeah, by the time I got the speakers yesterday, all of the light had completely gone, and I was really tired, so we're continuing today. So, basically, I've brought them up here. I've given them a quick wipe over. They've been on my wall in the old place for probably a good 6 years now, when I redid my room and put the home cinema system in. That's probably about 6 years. So they were a bit dusty, to say the least, but I've given them a quick wipe over, good enough for now. And I've brought them up here because I'm going to give them a good blast up here, and then we'll take everything down that we need and we'll fit it into the kitchen. I've got no idea what these are going to sound like. I honestly, because I've used them as part of a home cinema system and I've only used them in that scenario. Obviously, you have a sub, you've got a center channel, and you've got all sorts of different profiles and options within the receiver to, you know, tweak things and that. So I've never really heard these speakers true to themselves with an amplifier. I think I did that when I first got them, when I very first got them, but I can't remember. So I'm really, really looking forward to hearing if these are going to be any good. I'm really hoping that with this small EQ I can get a decent amount of low end out of them for the big-ish room that it is down there. But anyway, I'm going to cut up another bit of speaker cable for testing, because all of my testing speaker cable just seems to walk away. I don't know where it goes. But then we can plug it in and give it a go. So I thought I'd show you guys the back of these speakers just while I've got them here on the table. They don't say anything. They basically just say speaker system, impedance 8 ohms, input power 50 watt. And obviously that doesn't give you much information, but, you know, they're just, as I said yesterday, just sort of generic, small, you know, just after the turn of the century sort of mini hi-fi kind of speakers. At least that's what they look like. And as I say, I bought them in the car boot sale for a fiver. So yeah, let's turn the amplifier on, and I've already got this thing powered up. Let's get my phone out and get a song queued up, and I'm gonna have a little listen, and then I'm gonna find something that shouldn't offend the copyright, and then we'll have a listen together. So folks, I'm using Mindfield to show you guys what this sounds like, or give you at least an idea through the camera microphone. Because I used it in the video I made about the amp, and it didn't seem to give any copyright issues, apart from maybe blocked in Switzerland or somewhere. So massive apologies to any of you in Switzerland that have had to go a roundabout way to watch this video. But these speakers are great. There's loads of low end for what they are. And the only snag with these speakers, and I remember what the snag is. As soon as I listened to them for like 4 or 5 seconds, I remembered when I listened to these a few years ago, the tweeters have got a weird sort of buzzing kind of effect. Certain frequencies cause like almost like a clicking type effect. I'm not sure if they're damaged, you know, when I bought them or something, or if they're just cheapo tweeters, which they are obviously, but you know, cheapo, rough sounding. They sort of have like a sort of clicky kind of effect to them. It's really, really odd, but you can only notice it in certain songs, certain frequencies. And yeah, other than that, the quality is really clear. Obviously, the quality is even clearer when you put the EQ in on this amp. I wish there was somewhere in between this setting and the off setting. Sorry, this setting and the on setting, because this has got much more mid-range, which I like, but then you can't increase the low and high end. So when you put the button in to engage the EQ, you lose quite a bit of volume if you want to retain that that amount of mid-range with this amplifier. That's something that I've noticed. Yeah, that makes one hell of a difference. But anyway, as I say, pretty pleased. I'll give you guys a little blast. Plenty of volume as well for a kitchen sound system. That bass line is incredible. Sounds really, really nice. Yeah, everyone that knows me and has to spend time with me around sound systems is probably sick of hearing this track. Absolutely sick. But honestly, guys, I'm telling you, this is a brilliant testing track. Anyway, I'm going to have a tiny bit, like 2-3 more minutes of fiddling while I finish my morning coffee. And then we'll take this lot down and have a listen. Or indeed set it up and then have a listen. Well, folks, I'm really happy. Sounds great, and it'll be a lovely little system. So let's power it down, and I'll grab all the stuff I need to set this up downstairs. It's not going to be anything fancy. It's not going to be any crazy, you know, hidden installation job. It's just going to be me with a couple of cable ties, making it look as tidy as possible. I was basically going to use these points to mount it to the side of the cupboard, but then we fit shelves down there, so I'm just going to put it underneath one of the shelves. So yeah, let's go. Right then, folks, here we are in the kitchen. Now, the basic plan is we've got these cupboards and I've got the ladder out. So basically, I'm thinking one speaker there and one speaker on that one. Obviously, way too high for any kind of hi-fi listening experience, but you know, just to fill the room with sound as a kitchen system, a general system while you're cooking and doing the dishes and things, I think that would be perfect. So the main goals will be mounting the amplifier underneath this shelf here. The reason I'm going to mount it all the way over here is because it's close to the mains electricity, which is indeed there. And what I think I'm going to do with this, folks, is as kind of an awful solution as this is, I'm going to buy one of those four ways without an actual extension cord on it. So it's basically just a plug and then a four-way directly underneath there. I have seen them around in shops. And then I think I can put USB power, amplifier power and all this, because this is microwave and radio. Obviously, I'm going to have to unplug the microwave in order to get power to the amplifier, but that's okay for now. So we'll put the amp under there, maybe a couple of rows back, because it doesn't really need to be accessed, and then run the cables along the underside or back of the shelf, up the side of the cupboard, and then into that speaker and into that speaker. So that's no big deal. For cable management, I brought these down with me to help me if I need them. They're cable clips for the side of the cupboards. And also, I've got cable ties so that I can tie the speaker cables behind the shelf. It would have been awesome if I had grey cable ties, but I don't have any. It was a choice between bright yellow and black, so I'm going for black. And I was going to mount the amp, as I said, on the side of this cupboard, right about here-ish. But then we put the shelves up. And that's actually quite a good thing, I think, because it'll sort of hide the amp a little bit more. It'll blend in a bit. And yeah, I'm not going to put it on the side of the cupboard because you never know in the future what kind of items you want to put here. Like now it's these bowls, but in the future it could well be something much bigger. So I'm not going to have anything here hindering the setup. Plus then power becomes an issue because the transformer cable's only short. So I'd have to run some kind of extension and blah, blah, blah. So yeah, that's basically what I'm going to do. So first of all, I'm going to get a rough idea of what speaker length I need. And we're going to pop the speakers up on the cupboards. So there's one up there. If you guys are wondering about those eggs and you don't watch the vlog channel, they're basically pickling. We're pickling our own eggs at the moment. We're going to give them out as Christmas presents and stuff. But yeah, it looks okay up there. I mean, if you step back a bit, it looks quite good. You've got two contrasting browns. So you've got like the dark brown of the speaker and then the lighter brown of the cupboard. But that's fine. I think once the other one's up and they're a pair, it'll look good. So I've got a length of speaker cable that I was using upstairs. This will be fine for the first run. So what I'm going to do is leave this dangling here, fit the amplifier, and then we're going to run some cabling over because that way I'll get a better idea of how much length I need for that one as well. So folks, to get a rough idea, it is literally going to be that. And as you can see, that looks pretty good. Not bad at all. Just a little tip from me, which is a rarity when it comes to DIY related things, but I don't even think that this comes under DIY. This just comes as cable tying something to something else. But yeah, because these are open-ended holes on the side of the amplifier, you can actually put your cable ties in first as long as you don't over tighten. Then just clip the amplifier in as if you've, you know, got clips for it down below, and then tighten them up and chop them off. So that's actually really, really much, much easier than trying to hold the cable tie in the side of the amp while you're trying to thread it around whatever you're tying it to. If these were closed, then that would be the ideal solution, but with this method, it's much easier. So there we have the amp mounted. Now, of course, one thing that I've done which looks incredibly ugly is I've left that little block there and that one there, so they're not actually symmetrical, but once you have your stuff on the shelf, it'll be difficult to actually notice that. And you can see the Bluetooth thing is dangling out the back. Doesn't look too bad, actually. And if we need access to that button, then it'll be easy to press. It looks as if it's meant to be there. But if we don't need access to that button, there's nothing stopping me just tying it up there. I might do that anyway. It would help if I actually pointed the camera at what I was filming. Or maybe just stick it to the side of the amplifier with a bit of double-sided tape there. That looks pretty good. That actually looks better. Or underneath. Underneath is even better, although saying that the charging port is there. So yeah, we'll see what happens. Anyway, I'm gonna run some speaker cable. Progress, folks, progress. I've got both speaker cables in the back and they're tied back there. I'll chop all the ends off when I'm done. So I've got to take all these saucepans off so that I can just run that along the edge. And the other end of this one for this is still on the spool, so I can get the exact right length when I run the cable over the back of all this stuff. I'm hoping, anyway. At the moment, I think it's going to be quite visible because there doesn't seem to be an available slot behind this extractor fan to feed it through. And there's no hope of going underneath and back up either because it's all flush to the wall. So yeah, hopefully I'll be able to conceal it, but let's first get this part of the job done. That is pretty much the tidiest job I can do. And it's not that bad. It's pretty good, I think. Now, the only snag I've got here is I should have really thought about this. Instead of dropping down the side, I should have dropped down the first level here, the other side of this bracket, because as it stands, if I want to continue, I'll have to go under the bracket and back up the side of the cupboard. So what I'm going to have to do is unplug that speaker and also guess so that I can, because obviously this spool won't fit down the back of the shelves. I'm going to have to guess that so that I can get it coming up here and into that cable grip there. So up there it needs to come, not up there, because otherwise you'll just get a lump, like a loop of copper underneath. There we are, guys. Look at how clean that is. That is super, super clean. So in case anyone was confused with my rambling in the last clip, the cables were originally coming under this bracket. I wanted them to go over, and hopefully you can see exactly why now, because then it's hidden at the bottom. It just goes straight up into that grip, into the next grip, and over into the cupboard, or on top of the cupboard. So I've basically got two lengths now. I've got this length, here, which is for the other speaker, which I hope is perfect length, and then this length, which is for that speaker, which is a little too long, but gives me room to maneuver in the future if I want it. And then it's just, well, yeah, the home stretch then. I'll plug this into power and we'll give it a whirl. And if anyone's wondering what that random can is up there, I got given that as a present from the My Hermes delivery guy, believe it or not. And he is, I can't remember what country he's from off the top of my head now, but yeah, that's beer from his country, so sweet. Kept the can there as a little bit of a sort of ornament. Anyway, I'm going to plug this stuff in. Well, I personally think that looks pretty damn good. We are sorted. I got a couple of little cable tacks. I tacked one there. It is tight underneath the extractor fan. Apologies for all the grease, folks. I'm still looking for replacements for this. And then tacked it up the side. And it is tacked at the top, and you can barely see it. So I'm very, very happy with that. Very happy. We have one more thing to do, and that is the easiest part, plugging it in. Well, guys, it is working exactly how I wanted it to work. I'll put the saucepans back. It looks good. Sorry about all the mess, guys. Blinking heck. It looks good. As you can see, the transformer lead is dangling, but as you guys know, the power solution is temporary anyway, so that's to come with the four-way over here and things, so I've got to sort that out. But in terms of the sound, very, very happy. And also, the response to using the volume on your phone rather than the volume on the amp, it copes very, very well with that. So yeah, let's have a listen. So, low end is surprisingly nice actually. It's a bit boxy sounding in here, but that's to be expected, considering where the speakers are and things like that. Vocals sound really nice in this room. I've been listening to a few different tracks. Let me see, what other tracks did I use for non-copyright? Do you know, I'm gonna risk it, folks, and I'm gonna play a little bit of the old Simple Minds Breakfast Club soundtrack. You know, the... That's as much as I'm gonna risk. Okay, so as you guys can hopefully hear, it sounds pretty good. So everyone, that is my kitchen sound system complete. I'm really pleased with it. I think it's cool. I did notice that you can get Bluetooth versions of this amplifier, but a lot of them had like USB ports and SD card slots and all sorts of things like that. And I'm quite happy with the simplistic approach of this particular setup. Plus it gives me flexibility in the future because if I want to go the Airport Express route in the future sometime, if I can find a cheap Airport Express, then of course it'll be nice to just have the amp as a basic amplifier with no bells and whistles. But yeah, super, super pleased. I hope you guys have enjoyed this little project. It was something a little bit different. Expect more little projects around the house as I gradually improve things and introduce tech. All over the place, like I said, I was going to, and obviously, you know, we've got the living room set up to continue with and all sorts of things like that, so plenty more of this sort of thing to come. Thank you very much for watching, everyone, and as always, I'll see you in the next video.